The National Library for the Blind has a Braille eReader program where they send out these loaner Braille displays. This particular one is a Zoomax Braille display, but they also have humanware ones. All you have to do is make sure you're a patron of NLS and call them and register for this program. It will really depend where you are and what state you're in, how they will run the Braille eReader program, and when they will have it ready. I know for North Carolina, I called them all of last year to ask if their program was ready, and I finally got it in the middle of December 2023. So the best thing is to call and ask them exactly how the program works in your state. Hi, I'm Carrie on Accessibility, and I talk about technology and accessibility. If you're interested in that type of video, hit the subscribe button and the bell so you can stay up to date on the latest videos. Braille displays and note takers can be in the thousands of dollars, but a relatively new program with the NLS provides these as loaner equipment, just like they have the book players, and they can send out cartridges of audiobooks, or you could use Bard, which is available on iOS and Android. I think this is a great program. Already I am using this to practice my Braille. My Braille is not the best. I read pretty slowly. I'm working on grade 2 and I love this thing. When they sent this to me, it comes with a cartridge with some starter books, and I started trying to read those. I called the library and they told me that I could put Bookshare books on here. I haven't tried it out yet, but I think this can be really helpful and make Braille technology more accessible. I recorded myself unboxing this device, so I'm gonna show that to you guys now while we go over what it came with and some of its main features. This video has been brought to you by the Carry On Accessibility YouTube and Patreon members. If you'd like to support this channel and what I do here, please consider becoming a COA member. When you first open the box, the first thing you'll find is the Braille user manual. Below that, there's also a quick start guide, and then there is a cartridge. It looks and feels identical to the audiobook cartridges. There's also a USB-C to USB-A adapter. There's also a lanyard that you can attach to the device so you can put it around your neck, and an adapter for the cartridge. So you plug the cartridge into the adapter and then you plug the other end into the device. There's also supposed to be a felt marker on the cartridge so that you can know that this is a Braille book cartridge. And of course there is a USB wall adapter. Then you have the device itself that has a nice leather case on it, and it has these two magnetic clasps, and you can open that and then you can start typing away on the keyboard like I did. They are very, very clicky buttons. The on and off buttons are on the right side along with a USB-C and a USB-A port. These ports all have Braille labels next to them. There's the sound that it makes when it turns on. There's nothing on the top edge. And on the left edge, there is an SD card slot. On the front of the device, it has 8 Braille keys, a space in the middle, and below that are 20 Braille cells. There are 3 buttons stacked vertically on the left and 3 on the right. Below that, there are 2 smaller buttons horizontally, a larger button, then a kind of D-pad with a button in the middle, another large button, and then 2 more smaller buttons. The device also has Wi-Fi, so you can connect directly to Bard from this device, and it also has the NFB Newsline, which is another NLS patron service. You're also supposed to be able to use this like a Braille display if you connect it to your computer or mobile device, but I have not tried this yet. I also want to mention that you can really hear the Braille refreshing on this device, and I don't really have anything to compare it to, but it does sound a little loud. This is what it sounds like when it turns off. And there you have it. If you want more in-depth information, I recommend that you talk to your local Library for the Blind and ask them those questions. And they also have a lot of tutorial videos once you do get your Braille e-reader. I don't really feel confident, and I'm not an expert with Braille, so I'm not really going to go over how to do these things because the analysts have already made such great videos and tutorials on how to do this. Plus, they have a user manual, and you can also ask them to send you an email with a digital copy of the user manual. I think this is a great program. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and let me know down in the comments what you think and if you called your local library and if you get your Braille eReader. That's it for this one. Thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next video.